The next part of alimentary canal is small intestine. Now, the name small intestine is given on the basis of its diameter. The diameter of small intestine is less compared to large intestine, but small intestine is the longest part of alimentary canal. The length of small intestine is 6.25 meter. Generally in exam they ask you why small intestine being the longest part called small intestine. The answer is related to diameter. The diameter of small intestine is less compared to large intestine. Now speaking about its parts. Small intestine is divided into three parts: duodenum, jejunum and ileum. Now let's see what is the description of each part. Speaking about duodenum, in Latin, duodenum means 12 finger structure. So 12 finger structure is called as duodenum. So the length of duodenum is 12 finger of your hand. Now this is the widest part of small intestine and also the beginning part. Next is jejunum. Jejunum is the longest part, but it is smaller compared to ileum. It is longer compared to duodenum, but smaller compared to ileum. The length of jejunum is 2.5 meter and the length of ileum is 3.5 meter. Duodenum is 25 centimeter. So when you add 2.5 meter, 3.5 meter and 25 centimeter, you get approximately 6.25 meter. So this is how the length of small intestine is calculated. Now students, speaking about duodenum, jejunum and ileum, they are coiled structure, convoluted structure present in our abdominal cavity. The inner lining of all these three parts consists of villi-like structure. That villi-like structure helps to increase the surface area for absorption. Now I will show you with the help of diagram how this villi look. Now this is finger-like projection present on the inner lining of small intestine. This finger-like projections are called as villi. Villi, you can see internally it has a supply of vessels. Both the vessels, lymphatic as well as blood vessel supply, is present inside the villi. Now, what is the function of villi? Villi increases the surface area for absorption. Now, you can see this thing, student. When it is simply a tubular structure, it got only this much surface area for absorption. But when the structure is increased like this, or if they have a structure like this, then it is increasing the surface area. Compared to your hand. When your hand is without finger, it got only this much surface area. But if there is a finger-like projection present, you can see this is the surface area for absorption. And this is said that presence of villi increases the surface area for absorption of nutrient. One important thing, complete digestion occurs in small intestine, because almost all nutrients are absorbed in small intestine. Now speaking about some other things which are present in small intestine. There are presence of some intestinal gland. There are presence of some lymphatic glands. Now intestinal glands are present between two villi. If this is one villi, this is another villi. Over here you can see two openings. The first opening will be for the intestinal gland. Now what is the function of intestinal gland? Intestinal gland secretes intestinal juices. Now which is the second opening, and for what purpose that second opening is present? That second opening is for the lymphatic gland, and the lymphatic gland which is present in small intestine is lacteal gland. Now what is the function of lacteal gland, student? You all know in your body fats get deposited very easily, but there is one organ where the fats doesn't get deposited, and that organ is small intestine. Now just imagine, student, if small intestine have fat deposition on its surface, that is on villi, what will happen? So if there is a fat deposition on villi, absorption of nutrients will be blocked. That is why over here there is a presence of lacteal gland which destroys or which absorbs all the fats and convert it into cholesterol, which is used for the formation of lymph. Lacteal gland is a type of lymphatic organ. Now this is all about structure of small intestine. Thank you very much, students.